Today's letter reading is being offered for Pernella Mitchell, requested by Pearlie and Alice LaChance, and for Edwin Atkins Sr., as requested by John T. Sleeman. And today's liturgy begins on page 108.
Celebrate the day he manifested himself to the world. Lord, be with you, the Father, and the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, O Lord, at your divine baptism in the Jordan River, you revealed that you are consubstantial with the Father and the Holy Spirit. Enlighten our minds and our hearts on this day of your great epiphany. Make us holy by the indwelling of your Spirit, and make us worthy to celebrate this feast of lights, so that we may glorify and thank you, and your Father and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Lord,
You became the way and the door that leads us to the Father. Grant us your grace and mercy, and accept the fragrance of our incense, that we may raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father and your Holy Spirit, forever.
Which the Lord gave for building you up. and not for tearing you down. I will not be ashamed of them. I do not want to seem as though I am trying to frighten you with my letters, for they say, his letters are weighty and strong, but his bodily presence is weak, and his speech contemptible. Let such people understand that what we say by letter when absent, we will also do when present.
Praise be to God always.
But that's not what he is saying. Even if we knew Jesus a year ago, or 2 years ago, or 5 years ago, or 50 years ago, we still don't know everything there is to know about him. Each and every day should be a new discovery about who Jesus is, how much mercy and the power that he has to forgive, and how he can change our life or walk with us through troubled times. You know, and the other part was, is, you know, why did he wait till he was 30? You know, he was a perfect kid, and he was going to be fantastic. He would know everything. He could have started right out of college. Well, they didn't have college, but he was done being trained as a carpenter. Or he could have said, well, I don't want to do this. Let me get out there and get myself famous. But that's not the case either. You know, I thought about what kind of emotions go through our minds when we finally get the job that we want and we show up on the first day or the second day. Is there a little bit of fear? Am I going to get fired? Am I going to do all right? Do I think I know everything and I'm going to be the best employee they ever hired, and find out that when you come to work that you really don't know everything you thought as much as you thought you did? That is probably the correct way of feeling about life. That we never know as much as what we could know and would be to our advantage. And the people who act like they know everything and have the answer for everything, those people kind of upset us. The know-it-all, I like to rub it in our faces. There's a way to train and teach, and there's a way to show off what you know and embarrass the other person and make them feel like they're nothing. The reason I say something along that line is that up until now, Jesus did not have to deal, as far as we know, with rejection. That he was still growing in wisdom, but I'm sure he was quite confident in himself. That his parents certainly tried to protect him from the harshness of reality, even though I'm sure by then he had observed much of it. But he had to make some kind of an exchange here. In a mystical way, up until now, he was dependent on his surroundings, his physical surroundings, for all the love that he would need to do what he had to do up until this point. Tradition says that Joseph had died by now, we're not certain. So he only had one parent there to care for him, which was Mary, and I'm sure she did an outstanding job. As any mother, and I think any father knows that no matter how much love you have for your child, no matter how much concern and care that you have that they are protected from the world, that they will make the right decisions each and every time, you can't go through life in some area that you have some kind of anxiety or worry, or at least spend a lot of time praying for your children. I know when I was growing up, my brothers and I would say, what in the world is Mom and Dad talking about all the time downstairs? Not until we were growing up did we realize that they spent all that time talking to each other, probably because of us. And that's how life is, a conversation. A conversation to grow and to learn, to get a better idea, to get a greater perspective of life, to calm our fears, to give us another way of looking at life so that we're not torn to pieces by some of the things that enter into our life. When we feel tired and drained and we don't know how we're going to continue on, we need a conversation with someone to help us regain our strength. And that's where a good friend comes in, on a good relationship. There is a lot of potentials and possibilities out there to have the wrong kind of friend to introduce us to ways of feeling good about ourselves that wind up being very destructive. rather addictive. But in some mysterious way, I think Jesus had to go through the same thing. Because in order for him to identify with me, and to be able to identify with you, he has to have something more than just pure knowledge of being God and knowing it, but being a wonderful, loving man, human, to also know it. And I could probably spend all day reflecting on what does that mean to have two natures, to have within yourself two ways of dealing with life at the same time. And he did it for us. So when he went down into that water, it wasn't because he had to be purified, but he also had a chance to find out what are some of the things that we need to be purified from. What kind of emotional and mental and spiritual agony did some of those people that came to the preaching of John the Baptizer, that they wanted to go down into that water and be washed away the sins and the trauma and the burdens that they carried. Now, it's true the Holy Spirit wasn't there in the same way that he is in baptism, but I'm sure when they came back up out of the water, even on the human level, they must have felt cleansed in some way. I think it is so ingrained in our nature to use water to cleanse ourselves that is used constantly, that symbol. When a person has had something horrible happen to them, the first thing they want to do is either take a bath or a shower, and to somehow symbolically to get rid of that icky feeling. Well, Jesus didn't need it, but he wanted it. He was willing to go down there, knowing that probably some of those people up on the hill were saying, look at, and he thought he was such a nice guy, and everybody thought he was perfect. I wonder what he did that he had to go down into that water. Well, he knew what the people up on the hill had done, and were thinking and feeling. But he went down it anyway. He took the chance that he could be misunderstood, misinterpreted, and he knew what kind of venom can be up there on the hill. And he even done it for them. That's the kind of love that Jesus has for us. But he wasn't fond of us. In some of their gospel story, they said it was like thunder. Powerful. Gives you goosebumps and chills. Makes something deep inside vibrate. As a human, he wanted to feel that. As being divine, he knew it. We all need this voice. This is my beloved Son. This is my beloved daughter, on whom my favor rests. Now the Spirit is there. The darkness disappears. And part of the liturgy in the Code says that creation was so thrilled that this man of God was going down in the water that even the water leaped up to greet him. It's a way of saying that all creation wants to be rejoined with their Creator in a way that they're not now. That when Jesus says he came to bring a new earth and a new heaven, it means that the earth that we know and all the beautiful things that we see and experience and have treasured and loved
are not removed from us, but are also restored by Jesus going down into the water and to sanctify us. With this strength, with this encouragement, with these words from the Heavenly Father, the Word made flesh, who created all, comes back up out of the water, changing the earth with the power to change me and to change you, as long as we keep looking at him. Because he's always looking at us with mercy and compassion, to lift us up, to carry us on. And I can't think of anybody I've ever met in this world that could not benefit from this voice, this power, this peace, this joy. At this time, I'm going to bless the Epiphany water. And when I sprinkle, throw water at you, think of all those little burdens that you have. And this symbolically is meant to rinse them away, to renew your baptismal sacrament, and to find once again that peace. Because this 30-year-old man left the security of home to walk in the insecurity of our lives.
O Christ our Lord, whom the angels are unable to see because of the blazing fire on your face, you were born and baptized and have brought sanctification to us. We petition you, O Christ.
O Lord God, hear us. O Lord, for the salvation of all people, you have ordered your marvelous mysteries through water. Hear our prayers and shower your blessing upon this blessed natural element. Through it may your creation serve your mysteries, and may it receive the power of your divine grace. May the homes of the faithful be blessed and protected by the sprinkling of this water. May evil and harm be scattered, guilt and misfortune be washed away, the spirits of malice and darkness be cast out. And the peace that we invoke in your holy name, come and reign among us. We will glorify you, O Christ the Father, in your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. May the water be purified in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. If I miss you, you can raise your hand.
Sprinkle me with hyssop, that I may be pure. Wash me, and make me whiter than snow. Sprinkle me with hyssop, that I may be pure. Wash me, and make me whiter than snow.
Grant this to our Lord, and Savior Jesus Christ, to whom his glory is due, and may your mercy be upon us all, now and forever. Amen. This time we'll have a collection.
Consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things are made, for us and in our
and your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us, we call upon his offering all those who please God to add it to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered, for bread and forever. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Amen.
If I am a debt I
thee, if the will of was Oh,
our Lord. Mi alma adictam hasha le maver hadie, sab lachmo mina kadishata, barek kadesh, what so mi avatam mida karma,
so that none of your faithful may perish,
every giant bishop and all the bishops of the true faith, with blameless lives and a purity and holiness, may they guide your church and present you a faithful people who honor your name. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, your people here before you, especially those who have presented these offerings. Forgive them so that they may always live blameless lives in your presence and recognize the blessings you bestow upon them. For you are good and rich in graces, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, civil leaders throughout the world, that they may stand for justice and establish peace. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those who struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for peace throughout the world, especially in the Middle East and Africa, and an end to war and all acts of violence and hatred. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for an increase of vocations to the priesthood and a consecrated life to serve the Maronite Church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all those who pleased you from the beginning, especially Mary, the Holy Mother of God, the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors, John the Baptist, Stephen, the archdeacon, St. Joseph, St. Jude, and St. Mary. Assist us through their prayers and make us worthy to rejoice with them in your kingdom. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the fathers and teachers of the true faith who have endured sufferings for the sake of your church and your people. We truly and faithfully follow in their footsteps. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the faithful departed, especially Bryn and Edward, who have left us and have gone to the rest, hoping in you, awaiting a life-giving voice calling them to life. Accept the offerings we present to you on every hand, and have mercy on them in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins we have committed, and live without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us in the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things. With the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and that of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, is now, and shall be forever.
Power and glory.
is the kingdom of your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of him, and receive the blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, bless your faithful people who bow before you. Deliver us from all harm, and make us worthy to share in these divine mysteries, in purity and holiness, that through them we may be forgiven and made holy, and we raise glory to you, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal consubstantial be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiven blood. May our communion be for the forgiveness of our sins and for the life. O Lord,
thank you.
thank you, O Lord, and praise the glory to you, for giving us your body to eat and your living blood to drink. O Lord of all people, have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, O compassionate and merciful one. O Lord of all people, have mercy on us.
The Knights of Columbus are having turkey dinner on the 23rd of this month. Larry Mitchell is selling tickets after liturgy. Monday, I fly to Florida for the Maronite priest retreat. If it gets warmer out here than down there. And if any of you win the lottery, remember the church. And if I win the lottery, we'll have a reverse collection. Hopefully that won't get me in trouble. It'll be worth it. But pray for me and the Maronite priests who will be making their retreat, that we will return safe and sound and renewed and filled with zeal. We thank you, Lord God and Father, and ask that this divine communion be for the forgiveness of sins and the glory of your holy name, that your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lord Jesus, our God and Savior, you became flesh for our sake, and by sacrifice yourself you saved us. Deliver us from damnation and make us temples of your holy name, for we are your people and your inheritance. We glorify and honor you, your Father and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Go in peace, my beloved brothers and sisters. With the nourishment and blessings you have received from the forgiving of the Lord, may the blessing of the Most High Trinity accompany you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the one God, to whom be glory forever.
Amen.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.